II and the Korean Conflict veterans. It is also the fourth anniversary of the memorial bench honoring the Iraq and Afghanistan veterans. These veterans from Monterey County gave the ultimate sacrifice serving their country. We will now observe a moment of silence to recognize our prisoners of war and those missing in action. Let us remember and never forget their sacrifices. May God forever watch over them and protect them and their families. Okay, Bella will be reciting the Pledge of Allegiance, so please join Bella in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag.
Thank you.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, now, Barbra Ann, our junior member of Unit 31, will sing the National Anthem.
Cool.
I was impressed. I thought that voice came out of me.
Thank you so much.
All that came out of you.
Blessing upon them and upon those for whom the war conflict is not over. Teach us to honor them by ever cherishing the ideals for which they fought and died. Inspire us by their example to live, that we may die worthy of their sacrifice. We ask your blessing upon this service. May it uplift us all to constant devotion to your teachings and to the welfare of our country. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, I'm sure. The red poppy is a nationally recognized symbol of sacrifice worn by Americans since World War I to honor those who served and died for our country in all wars. It reminds Americans of the sacrifices made by our veterans while protecting our freedoms. They answered their country's call to arms. Into battle they did go. Where their final destination was, no one will ever know. May their final resting place under some unsown sod be forever hallowed, for it is known only unto God. Emily will go ahead and read on Flanders Fields.
In Flanders Fields. Flanders Fields, the poppies blow between the crosses, grow on the ground. our place, and in the sky the larks, still bravely singing, fly, scared, curved, and hid the bird. We are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt gone, saw sunset glow. We loved and furloughed, and now we lie on the planet. Pick up our quarrel with the foe. Break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep. Though poppies grow, we plant a tree.
And Bella Godotti at this veteran, here. V is for victory, our many veterans brought. E is for everyone who went afar and fought. T is for the thanks we gladly give to them. E is for the endless hours they fought for us to win. R is for royalty, patriotic and true. A is for America, the red, white, and blue. N is for now and forever they remain in our hearts.
That's so awesome.
Very moving.
I'd like to elected commander of 31 JR. Say a few words.
Good afternoon. As you know, I'm new elected post commander of 31. I want to thank everybody coming here. This is new to me, and I'm here to support these ladies 100% every week.
You heard it?
Yeah. I just put my foot in it. But again, thank you.
Okay, well, thank you.
Thank you for speaking.
Okay, and let me have Ben say words of wisdom.
You're a veteran.
No. Then I'll get myself.
Good afternoon, everybody. We've been coming here now for a number of years, the American Legion Riders, and we have a bench here that is honoring those that are from this area that have made the ultimate sacrifice in defense of our country. And I see Vietnam vets here, and Middle East conflict vets here, and I'd just like to say that for us old guys, it's meaningful for us whether we're honoring World War II or Korea or Vietnam or the Middle East. It's important for us to remember those people that gave everything they had. And it's especially important to remember their family because they're the ones that are still here and still hoping for healing of those wounds.
Thank you.
Okay, next we have Mai, who's a son of the American Legion.
So it might seem curious to have a non-veteran speak at an occasion like this, but you know, being the sons of the American Legion has given me the opportunity to honor my father's service. My father was a World War II veteran. Served in the Merchant Marine, which is probably the most under-recognized unit that fought in that war. Many people don't know that the Merchant Marine suffered a higher casualty rate than the other branch of the service. And the Merchant Marines that survived the war were not recognized as veterans until 1986. Regrettably, my father had passed away before that happened and never knew the recognition of his fellows who served in the war. So when I stand here before you, grateful for your appearance here to honor these World War II veterans that are commemorated by the Rose Garden. So the heart that is in them, yeah, my father, who I am grateful for people who honor and remember. As far as the casualties of the recent conflicts, I look at that bench and I see those names that I have personally ridden in escorts for 9 of the 11 KIAs, sons of Monterey County that have have been sacrificed in the current conflict. It stirs my heart and it gives me a sense of pride that I can be there and comfort a mother, shake the hand of a father who has lost a son. And to me, that's what this day is all about. As Vin said, remember those who've passed on, but comfort the families because they still feel the loss. So that's our charter for being here today, and I'm proud to be part of it.
Okay, to all of our veterans, you are not forgotten. Thank you for your service to our country. As a grateful American, I know that our freedoms come at a very high cost, and I wanted to let you know that your sacrifice to our country is remembered and appreciated. God bless you, and God bless the United States of America. And this concludes our ceremony. And thank you for being here. I really appreciate it.